To our breaking news, Hawaii is in the grips of an unprecedented wildfire emergency. The situation so dire, some residents have jumped into the ocean to escape the flames.
Well, several fires are burning out of control on the island of Maui, which is packed with tourists on summer vacation. Joining us from the island of Maui is Clint Hansen. Clint, thank you very much for your time. Tell us, what is the current situation in Maui?
The current situation is we're reeling from a massive fire. Lahaina has been absolutely devastated. I live on the south side of the island, but I was actually in Lahaina the day of the fire. I have lots of friends and family out there. In addition to selling real estate, I also own the paintball field out there. So I'm really well connected to the community, and I could barely get to Lahaina yesterday because we were dealing with these windstorms, and they thought they had the fire under control and out. So they were dealing with another fire on the island. They were in actually Kula, dealing with evacuations and fires up there. So when it broke out, it happened in such high wind and so quick that it just burned the town down in a matter of hours. And there is video footage of people driving through flames, where at the flash point, where everything is burning, where you can see people having succumbed to asphyxiation on the ground. And they couldn't get out of the car to help them because they would have died. There's friends of mine, Kelly, Bryce, he's had rescue operations out there on his civilian vessel and rescued over 50 people, bringing them in. And they saw multiple people having perished, succumbing to the smoke and fire. It is unprecedented, the fact that the entire harbor has burned to the ground. We have no idea how boats sitting in the water on an ocean could burn so suddenly, but they're gone. Everything's gone. Our historical buildings are burned to the ground.
So just take us through it, because the fire itself is one thing, but Hurricane Dora, which is whipping up these winds, is causing major damage too. And is that why the ferocity and the speed of this fire has happened?
You know, it's Maui tends to have the best weather in the world. It's what we're known for. And it's actually been close to 180 years since we've had a direct hit from a hurricane. But when there's a big disorganized weather front that comes through, or if it comes so far in one particular direction and passes us like it has now, then the sheer winds off the big island don't get the opportunity to break it up. So we don't have really any clouds or inclement weather. We just have this wind that came out of, you know, the north and is blowing through, causing these problems. So it's our typical wind directions, but the ferocity of the wind combined with the power outage and the cables starting fires have really taken us by surprise,
Clint,
and caught us unprepared.
It's just horrific. We are hearing that people have been jumping into the water to try and escape the flames. We are hearing there will be loss of life. What can you tell us about that?
We don't have a sheer account of the numbers, but I wouldn't be surprised if it's a very high number, because right now we know at least three, if not four, people have passed away. I wouldn't be in the least bit surprised if that number comes a lot closer to 100, because everybody was caught off guard by the speed and the ferocity of this thing.
We're just hearing the Maui mayor has confirmed six people have died in this so far, and that is just broken then. Also, too, that hospitals being inundated with burn victims. Are you hearing that too?
Yes, most definitely. There's ambulances that were leaving Lahaina that were packed to the gills. From my understanding, one of them was stuck with about nine passengers in it, in addition to the EMR staff that was helping with the rescue. There's an unaccountable situation, because there's no ability to get footage out of Lahaina right now because everything's burnt down. So there is some stuff that's been coming out of aerial and helicopters going out, but we don't even know the full extent. But it sounds like a dozen businesses and hundreds of buildings were burnt down.
And so communications are down, 911 is down apparently. This
Correct.
Is an absolute catastrophe, Clint.
It is. I don't know how we're going to recover, because given it's one of the most desirable places on the planet for people to come and visit, our housing shortcomings have been dramatic. We have almost a 10,000 home shortfall. And now with this, and potentially hundreds, if not more, homes have been burned to the ground, we're going to be dealing with a disaster of epic proportions.
Yeah, it is just horrifying. If you are just tuning in this morning, it's 6:30 on Sunrise. Just recapping our breaking news. The devastating wildfires in Hawaii have turned deadly, with six people confirmed dead on Maui as ferocious wildfires sweep across. Residents and tourists have described apocalyptic scenes. Many locals say they were forced to jump into the sea to escape the fast-moving flames. Dozens of homes and businesses have been destroyed, and there are power outages right across the island. The fires are being fanned by high-speed winds from an approaching hurricane.
We're joined by real estate agent Clint Hansen on Maui right now. Clint, just take us through again Lahaina, which is the small town in Maui that has been devastated by this fundamentally. 13,000 permanent residents reside in that area, but so many tourists visit as well.
Yeah, it's a very well-known location on island. There, it's a historic location with buildings that are, you know, close to 100 years old, so they don't have the fire protections. And when yesterday's fire broke out or rekindled, they were caught off guard because there's multiple fires all over the island. So it rapidly burnt the whole town to the ground. And if you've seen any of the footage, that they, because of the graphic nature, they're taking it offline. There's people that have succumbed to asphyxiation, people driving through situations where everything is on fire at a flashpoint. Everything is burning and they're barely making it out. If they were to open their car doors, they'd be dead in a minute. Friends of mine are going out there to rescue the people that are jumping into the ocean last night. And I'm on maybe 2 hours of sleep because I've been posting videos to show the town that I'm at with one of the many fires that are on island that we've been fortunate enough to be sheltered from the wind. The Kihei and Wailea area has gotten away, fortunately unscathed, but upcountry is badly burned and Lahaina town is burnt to the ground. Kaanapali seems to be doing okay, but out and further, lower Honopilani, there has been some fires that have broken out. So it is really touch and go to get a full accounting of all the damage, but dozens of businesses are gone and hundreds of homes.
Clint, our thoughts are with you. We know that you are heavily connected with the community there and you have family as well, friends in and around the area. We hope that everyone that you know and are close to are well and accounted for. Thank you so much for spending a little bit of time in giving us an update on this horrible fire. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Have a great day. Aloha.
So it happened overnight too, and this is the thing. So 10:30 a.m. local time in Maui, the sun has only been up for a couple of hours. They're now starting to see some of the devastation. As you touched on, emergency services are down, communications are down. We don't have the ability to directly get into that area of Lahaina, that small town, and really understand the devastation. We've had confirmation, the Maui mayor saying that six people have died in these fires, and we're also hearing that the hospitals are inundated with burn victims. So very likely that we are going to see more on that number as well.
Yeah, we hear all airlines are sending more planes into Maui to try and get people off the island. The fact that people were jumping into the water to try and save their lives.
In the middle of the night.
Absolutely horrendous. Some of them were saved by boats, by Coast Guard staff. And we are now finding out that some will perish. It's just a horrible, horrible story. We'll bring you more as we get it.